my humble pranams at the lotus feet of our most beloved Bhagavan, distinguished guests, elders, office bearers, brothers and sisters. I am very thankful to Air Marshal Suni for his kind words, sir. I wish I deserved them all. I've been talking to different regions in Delhi and were proceeding in the same breath, in the same tune and rhythm. I would like to draw your attention, first of all, my friends, that let's not take it for granted that we are here on our own. Certainly not. Please be convinced. We are here selected, chosen by Bhagwan Sri Sat Sai Baba.
Absolutely.
It is not accidental, but it is existential reality. It is not a coincidence, but a divine providence. Understand it clearly. Secondly, we should be ever and ever grateful to Baba for the reason that he has given us a role to play in the divine mission, which is a privilege. What's that role? There's nothing like higher role, lower one, middle one, cara, hierarchy. No. In the divine incarnation of Lord Rama, squirrel played its own role. Squirrel. Monkeys play their own role. So it's a question, not a question of cada, but it's a question of our sincerity, the depth of our feeling that matters. We are very grateful to Swami for the privilege and the greatest of the blessings conferred upon us by allowing us to serve him. That is the second thing. Thirdly, I will also tell you, my friends, which is a naked fact, based on my observation across the globe. Had we not been exposed to Baba, I repeat, had we not been exposed to Baba, our life would have been totally different. Frustrating, disappointing, depressing, worldly, mundane, ephemeral, transient, senseless life, meaningless, purposeless life. After coming to Baba, life has become beautiful, meaningful, purposeful, most interesting, and the greatest fortune that we have earned in our lifetime. The worst of the things, the worst of the things that could ever happen in our lifetime is to forget Baba and lose at Sai Baba. Let it not happen for a lifetime and in the many more lives to come. Because this is an opportunity that we got after penance for several of the lives in the past. All the merit accrued in the past has been given to us. Let us not prove unworthy of it. Let us prove worthy of the chance given to us. Having begotten, having inherited lot of parental property, if you waste your property by gambling, what a fool you are. Similarly, the divine privilege, the divine opportunity, an instrument in avataric mission cannot be wasted, can never go in vain. We will make full purpose of it for the fulfillment of his mission by playing our own role. That should be our determination. I would also tell you, sometimes we feel that we are very important, but the fact of facts is we are very unimportant. Very unimportant. Because of our active service, because of our continuous involvement in service activities, we feel that we are indispensable, inevitable. No one is indispensable inside your organization. Please understand. I am doing so much. If you go, you'll be better substituted. Understand? If you go, most welcome people welcome your exit. Therefore, let's not think that I am doing, I am important. No, no, no. We are not important. Swami is important. His mission is important. This, if I do not participate in Sai activity, I am the loser. I am the loser. I can also tell you that we would like to postpone our involvement, our association with your Sai organization. I know many people have been in the Sai movement for the last 45 years. I met many people, they say, I'm busy, I have no time. You have all the time for gossip. You have all the time for politics. You have all the time for TV. You have all the time to fight with your wife. But you have no time for God. So to say that I have no time is bogus, number one. If you watch the life of every person carefully, you'll understand so much time is wasted. A portion of it can be spent for Swami, for your own advantage, for your own benefit, that we should understand that. So nobody should ever say, I have no time. Silly reason. Nobody is here to accept the cock and bull stories. No. And there are some that say, let my children settle, then I will come. Where is the guarantee that you will live till then? Your account may be settled even before. So let me not say, I will wait until my children settle. No, no, my friends. Each one has to settle down himself. Each one should be prepared. Not that I will do it later. Another point is this. If I say I will come after retirement, what are you after retirement? Blood pressure? Sugar? Cataract? Arthritis? Pneumonitis? Bronchitis? The second-hand body, Baba doesn't want it. You made use of your vitality. You made use of your life force. You made use of your dynamism to earn and to burn your life. You have not given a part of all of your dynamic life to Swami. Subject to correction, my friends. I see faces of many of my students here. I see some of very familiar faces here. Subject to correction. All Sai devotees look young, younger and younger day by day. It's very difficult to say their age. Why I say that? Because they bask in the grace, in the light of Bhagavan Sri Sathya. They are fully charged, taking several times a day the divine elixir, ambrosia, and amrit of Bhagavan's benediction. What more you want? It is more powerful than any latest multivitamin tablet. So, we don't age, please take it from me. Why don't we age? He will keep you busy. He will keep you busy. If life hangs something wrong with you, life never hangs. Life is never a burden. Come on, you can enjoy. We can participate in bhajans. We can participate in service activities. We can read Sai literature, make ourselves encourage and promote others, and also encourage others to participate. The secret behind youthhood or youthfulness of Sai devotees is Sathya Sai Baba, please understand. Sathya Sai Baba. It so happened one doctor from US, LA, he was asking Swami, "Swami, are you fine?" "Very fine, Bangara, very fine." "Swami, are you fine?"
"Very fine."
"Swami, are you fine? If you ask next time, I'll send you out of ashram." How is he fine? With fracture there, fracture here, a body that's not cooperative. Why he says, "I'm fine, why I'm fine"? The reason is, he feels fine when we are fine. Understand that, when we are fine. Yeah. He feels very happy when we are happy. Our happiness is his happiness. Therefore, if we walk along Sai path, taking his example as our divine hero, as he truly said, "My life is my message." If we just follow him, we can also be happy by making others happy. Unfortunately, it's lacking today. Many people are happy when others are unhappy. Therefore, they are continuously involved in the process of eternal torture, completely making other lives miserable. Therefore, we don't find a smile on their face. We don't find any smile on their face. You may walk miles and miles. Understand, we are cut off. Miles and miles away from smiles. We are not able to smile because we want to make others cry. How can you smile? Impossible. As Baba devotees, we should learn this, to bear all the suffering, to bear all the pain for ourselves. "How are you?" "Fine." But people don't say that. "How are you?" "Last night I didn't sleep properly." "How are you?" "I'm thinking of changing my doctor because medicines are not working properly." Who asked your bio data? Who asked your temperature? Who is interested in your blood pressure? On listening to you, I'm developing blood pressure. Kill joy, fellows. That's not correct. Baba never complains. There's no point of saying that, "Baba, you are great, you are God." He is great whether he's here or not. "Swami, you are great, you are God." He's God already. You don't need to certify. The quality of a devotee is to follow his footsteps. You know, Jesus who said, "Follow me, follow me." So we should follow him. What if that amazing, unbelievable thing is, he could contain all the problems and smile and bless everybody. Halaha, Elakanta Mahadeva. He contains all that, but that smile lasts forever. So, my friends, we should also contain all our problems, make everybody happy. Somebody asked me, "What is that Baba has given you?" Perhaps he expects that Swami has given me gunny load of currency notes, gunny bag tools. Of course, they are useless now. And some people ask me, "Has he given you ring or a chain?" I don't know. Somebody asked me, "Do you have a flat in Puttaparthi?" I tell them, "I have come here to fall flat in front of Baba, not to acquire a flat." Somebody asked me, "Do you have a plot near airport?" I tell them, "I have not come here
to plot against anybody. It is enough if I have a plot in the sight of Sai. In the sight of Sai, that is enough.
Some people ask me, do you have some site at least near super specialty hospital? I tell them, I have not come here to acquire the site. I would like to be in the sight of Sai. I don't acquire sight of Sai. Therefore, my friends, what we want today, the highest position is to have Baba in our hearts. The greatest achievement is to walk along his footsteps. The highest magnitude of sadhana, spiritual practice, is to emulate his qualities and values. It's not irrelevant if I tell you, at one time in Vrindavan, Swami was to be operated and he was taken in a stretcher. We were all there. Believe me or not, he was standing this side at first side, dancing here on the stretcher. Can you dream of it, next life at least? Impossible! If doctor says something wrong with you, finish, life is gone. There should not be any music at home. There should not be any cookies or special preparations. There should not be any laughter or visit by relations, because I am not well. How silly we are. We call ourselves Baba's devotees, but to what extent we have taken him as an example? Baba the Great. Baba the Great, who just shares happiness, who just spreads bliss in spite of any odd circumstances. And when people ask me, what is it Baba has given? It is true with everybody. My friends, even in the worst of the dreams, I would ever consider that I am more than anybody. Nobody is more than anybody. Let us understand that. Nobody is more than anybody. Everybody is as good as anybody. Please understand. I consider it very silly when some say, I am close to Baba. Oh, your chapter is closed once for all. How do you say that you are close to Baba? Did he ever say that you are close to him? Can God be close to some people? What sort of spiritual awareness you have? What sort of spiritual knowledge you have? God is the one who is close to everybody. Such as Sai Baba is close to everybody. Some of us feel very proud. Suppose if a young boy comes and tells, sir, I have been to Prasanthalayam for the first time. Or first time? I have been visiting it for the last 40 years. He did not ask you since when you started visiting. I'm interested to blow my own trumpet. But behind me will say, this Anil Kumar is going there for 40 years, he has not changed. It's an insult to me. There is no question of seniority. I'm very clear. There is no question of juniority or seniority. Nothing in the spiritual path. Please take it from me. All I say. In fact, those that join us later may be the first to be awakened. Baba himself gave an example. When the bus stops, even Delhi transport also I watched, when bus stops, people rush, chuck, chuck. They run and pushing everybody. The man who goes, gets into the bus, occupies the first seat, very close to the driver. When the last man will stand near the door, when the
Bus stops, the last man is the first to get down. The first man is the last to get down with the driver.
So it's not a question of when I came, how here I am, since how long I have been coming here.
It is not important, that important.
In fact, Baba also said, there are electric poles in Puttaparthi. They have been there for so many years. No change. So, what I mean to say is, my friends, let's not count our years. Let's not go by the number of years of service I have put in Sai Path.
No. Pleasant moments, divine moments, wonderful conversations, the sweet laughter of Swami, the wonderful jokes of Swami, the beautiful dancing style of walk of Swami, and the excellent dress of Swami. What? That you can think of it. Not your own life, your own seniority. There is no service register here. You are not going to be given any promotion or advanced increments. Why all this? By that, we lose that freshness. We lose that freshness. That's why the Holy Bible, it is clearly said, keep your love as the first love. First love. Your first love is pristine, pure, nascent, original. As years pass by, rotten, horrible, terrible. First love is gone. But in the spiritual path, every experience, every day, every dream is first love. As if I am meeting Swami for the first time. As if I am listening to bhajan for the first time. That keeps us fresh, brilliant and vibrant. And I will also tell you what we can learn from Swami. He is not for any pomp and show. He is not for that. It was that year when a conference of Akhil Andhra Sadhu Parishad, all Swamijis from Andhra Pradesh assembled there in Prashanthi Nilayam. All Swamijis, Akar Rogues and all, very popular people on the dais. That end to this end, the blue curtain opens, comes forward, looks that side and this side, suddenly goes to the center, sits one among them. Not on the chair specially meant for him. He sits one among them. To be common is uncommon. To be uncommon is quite common. Bhagavan is always common. He sat there. People were wondering, Swami would sit on the chair because he's a higher Swami. No, he sat there. And then what happens? The day's proceedings started. Next day, 3-day conference. I was there inside. And Swami Bhumananda, the head of Akhilananda Sadhu Parishad, from Kalyana Durga, very close to Anantapur, he came to Swami from behind to the dais. I was there, Swami. Yeah, me anta baagundi kada. Everything is fine. Bhojanalu erpatu chesinam kada. We are in food. Be comfortable kada baga. Are you comfortable? Swami, very nice. Then this what Bhumananda said. Swami, as long as you are here, devotees are here. The moment you get away, whole hall is vacant, excepting Sevadan in charge of shutters, that's all. Why, sir? Why to that extent? Kantasala, a very famous singer, Mandra Pradesh, he visited Prashanthi Nilayam. Another radio artist, Malik, also gave a performance in front of Swami. As ill luck would have it, they did not begin their program by touching the feet of Swami. He started, Sankara Nada Sarira. para, all the fellows para, para. All the fellows left. Para, para.
Why? They are not happy. I can tell you, my friends, if our talks are successful, if our music program is successful, if we are acceptable, it is entirely due to Bhagawan Sri Sathya Baba, not because of you. It's an open challenge to anybody. Let them come and address in Prashantalaya. Nobody will be there. If you are a student, your fellow students will be there as an act of charity. Because tomorrow he speaks, you should clap. Today you speak and he claps. Just a mutual sycophancy. But nobody will be there. Why? Bhagavan is the center of attraction. Bhagavan is the center. So all our activity, all our histrionic talents, all the honor is entirely because of Bhagavan. Sri Sathya Baba, let us be conscious about it. A second when you feel it is mine, there ends the matter. The gates of hell are wide open. You will be shown your correct position. Let us be aware of it. Bhagavan, you made us your students. You made us your staff. You made us sing. You made us act. This is all because of you. Without you, where would I have been? Nowhere in history. This is true with the lives of everybody, not necessarily students. A student does not mean who is enrolled in the university. Certainly not. Today, it is reverse also. Who is a student? The student is the one who follows his direction, who goes through his message, who propagates his message. He is only true Sai student and no one else. Take it from me, no one else. So we should absorb his message. We should be charged with all the energy. Carry on the message door to door. Then only you deserve to be called a student. Not by virtue of a transfer certificate or enrollment in the classroom, that any buffalo can get it done. That is not so. We should prove worthy of Bhagavan. Bhagavan should feel he is my student. He should be able to say that. I can also tell you a simple instance. It may be quite simple. When I was the state president, I had attended a meeting at Prashantalaya. I accepted one invitation already to address the villagers of Bhajan Mandali and to talk on the occasion of their anniversary. Because of state president meeting, I gave priority to that event. Swami came straight and said, please note that. There is nothing like village Bhajan Mandali and state president. All are same to Swami, understand it. All are same. All meetings are important. There is no cadre. There is no class. All are important, understand it. You give your consent, you absconded, and you are here. Very bad leader. That's what he said. Very bad leader. Because there is important meeting. What is important in the sight of Swami? All are important. Back home, what did I learn? Back home, three scholars, very well known in the entire state, they attended and they spoke without their names announced, without their names printed in the invitation. They came on their own. That is Bhagavan Sri Sathya Baba. Never say that I am doing it. He can get things done much better without you, without you. At one time Swami said, even in Chile, Swami ka satchamini kuri ditti kuda jen. Minun manun chegalun, samastam Swami ka astagatam nunnadi.
కానీ నా యొక్క భక్తుల యొక్క శక్తి నిమిత్తమై, నా యొక్క భక్తుల యొక్క ముక్తి నిమిత్తమై వారికి ఎందుకున్నటువంటి ఒక అవకాశం మాత్రమే.
What Baba said was, I can get all things done by myself. I don't need you. But for your liberation, for your redemption, for your salvation, for your advancement,
I am giving you this opportunity of service. Not that I cannot get along without you. That's what Baba said.
Whenever I attend any meeting, whenever I participate in any service activity, those words ring in my ears always.
Understand this is an opportunity, that's all. Don't lose it. If you lose it, lost forever and ever. There's no point in regretting later.
When grandchildren come and tell you, Tata, did you see Sai Baba?
I saw him once.
The modern grandchildren will tell you, what the hell you are doing? Swami was quite fair and healthy, he was moving actively, you saw him once.
I'm very sorry, grandsons. Today grandchildren are very smart. Those days we were smart, but we were silently smart.
But no silence today.
They are eloquently smart today.
They will tell you on your face. And in advanced age, I do not think I would have done it, I would have done it, I have thought of it. Stop that nonsense.
Swami, you gave all the chances. Swami, you gave all the privileges that I fully utilized, come what may.
Come what may. That's one thing. Then there are some that say, what about my professional prospects? What about my professional prospects? How about my professional obligations? I'm very busy. What about it? I don't want you to do like that, but simple example. One gentleman named Ramchandra Rao, block development officer, we call him BDO. He stayed at Prashantalyan for 3 days extra, without applying leave. The salaries had not to be distributed on the previous day.
Well, he went there, he went to the office,
thinking that he may be suspended. But what happened? When you open the register, he finds his own signature on only 3 days. The peon comes to him and asks him, sir, you said that we'll be going to camp this afternoon.
Ramaya, are we ready? Then I said, I came only now.
Why I tell you yes, my friends, when we do his work,
he will do our work much, much better than what we have done for ourselves.
There is a clear proof in the life of many, many of us.
It's not Anil Kumar exclusive experience. There's nothing like inclusive or conclusive. Everything is inexhaustible.
Everything is so vast. Everyone experiences it. I can also tell you, my friends, several such instances that happened. Three scholars known all over the state, they are invited to participate in Prashanti Vidwan Mahasabha proceedings on the sacred occasion of Dasara celebrations. Out of three, only one turned up, two did not. Swami looked at that person who turned up, Dr. Amarendra, the first principal of Puttaparthi College. Amarendra, the other two are old. They are comparatively young. You could get into the compartment through the window. They cannot go like that. Poor fellows, they are waiting. Don't worry, I kept rooms also ready for them. It only means he knows your plan. He knows your inconveniences. He knows your ordeals, all our sufferings, all the pain that we go through.
has all the more consideration for us than any near and dear. Another instance I would tell you was expected to be present on 21st, for example, so to say. But the scholar turned up on 22nd. When Swami says 21st, it is 21st. It cannot be 22nd, 23rd, no. This man came on the next day. He is Nipala Vijay Sastri. Very great scholar. Swami looked at him, Sastri. Oh, how are you? Yeni Brahmanandana Untive. Chala Brahmanandana Untivappa. Brahmananda meaning? Brahmananda meaning supreme bliss. Sastri, you are in supreme bliss. That's what others understood. But the inner meaning is this. That day, Brahmananda Reddy, the chief minister of Andhra Pradesh, was on official visit to Nellore. Vijay Sastri had to speak. So he could not attend on that day. Brahmananda Untive meaning, you are having supreme joy in front of Brahmananda Reddy. Forgetting Brahma himself. You serve Swami, you praise Swami, and you cannot compromise. You cannot bend down before anybody. You know that you are with royal Bhagavan Sri Satsangha. And this Deepak Vichesh has announced in front of everybody. Therefore, the lesson is that we cannot be cheap. We cannot be so cheap as to praise everybody. We cannot be so cheap as to punish everybody. But nothing. Having touched the feet of Bhagavan, let us not touch the feet of anybody. Having praised Bhagavan with this tongue, let me not praise anybody. Because greatest of all, having eaten gulab jam, would you take popcorn unless you are stupid? And having tasted the divinity of Bhagavan, we cannot come down. Let us enjoy that opportunity, that privilege continuously. I can also tell you, sir, Chief Justice of Andhra Pradesh, Justice Valluri Parthasarathy, he was invited to preside over a big function, state level meeting, at an auditorium held in the premises of the medical college. The whole city was present there. Dr. Parvantam also was the speaker. In a bit of emotion, the man announced. What did he say? You have the special privilege to have Chief Justice Parthasarathy, Chief Justice of High Court of Andhra Pradesh, as our chief guest. We are also blessed to have the gracious presence of Dr. Bhagavantam, the former Vice Chancellor of Andhra University, former Vice Chancellor of Usman University, Chief Advisor to the Scientific Council Government of India. We are very happy. He thought he did his good job. It is a good job indeed, collecting the data. Then it was the term of Valluri Parthasarathy. Please understand this. What did Chief Justice say? I have not come here as the Chief Justice of High Court of Andhra Pradesh. I have come here as the devotee of Bhagavan Sri Satsang. I consider this post, devotee of Bhagavan, is far greater than Chief Justice of High Court. That's what we are, that's what we are, that's what we are. Whereas never degrade yourself. Never consider you are too small. No, no, no. You are insulting your God. No. Because you are the legal higher, the Divyatma Swarupa, embodiments of Divine Atma. No, 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 I mean, that's the what? That's the retardist. A big dust for several lives to come. It's not that. You are with Swami. I shall not bear. I shall not compromise. God is by my side. Then Dr. Bhagavantam got up to give his talk. What does Dr. Bhagavantam say? I address many conferences, science congress, particularly field of physics, all over the world. But when I start speaking of Bhagavan, my legs tremble, my voice fumble, because I feel the divine presence here. Such great people of eminence, when they are so humble and simple, you can understand the power of God. The fellow is not humble and simple, he is just to wait for next life. Ah, so many lives to come. Humility is the hallmark of a devotee. I can give another example. Victor Kano from Zambia, who wrote many books on such as education in human values. Swami performed his marriage also. We know him. He's from Oxford. Excellent English. And Victor Kano served as the ambassador to the United States, UK, USSR, and whatnot. He served in various capacities. But visiting card carries only one sentence. Victor Kano, devotee of Sathya Baba. That's all. To say that Baba is not my God, to say that he is not my shepherd, it is declaring that his parents are no more. Baba is the divine parent of everybody. We should feel thrilled and excited, feel proud to say, I am the devotee of Baba. Why not? Why not? Why not? We should feel proud to say that. Why is it in Latin America, what you call South America, I got an invitation from the governor of Colombia. He wanted to see me and wanted to give me some cup of tea. So I went to see him along with our own friend Saidu, who is from the organization, well dressed. It's very important. We saw you what is our not so cheap. Yes, we are class one officer. Because class one is Sathya Baba, I am with him. Why so cheap? So all came in full sweep, slim and trim. We went to see that governor of Colombia, upstairs building. Baba is a witness. That man walks to the door. Anil Kumar, welcome, welcome to my office. He receives me. On the table, two flags, the flag of Colombia and the flag of India. And offered me a cup of tea. Introduced me to other members of the cabinet. Left to you, what are you? Without Baba, what are you? Who cares you after all? Who cares you? Who should understand you? Nobody. Then once the devotee of Baba, governor comes and receives you. Rajadi Raja Ramachandra Sahi Jagavandana. You should catch hold of the feet of such a Swami. Then in the course of conversation he said, I mean, well, you know why I called you? Yes, sir, I'd love to know that. Immediately, he took out the button there and brought out the chain, materialized for him by Bhagavan Sri Sathya Baba. This is the chain that Baba has given me. I saw you on the dais translating his talks, but I want to see you in close quarters. I want to see how you look. Therefore, I asked you to come here. Sir, it's a matter of pleasure. And he came up to the end yet and waved his hand, thank you, see you again. Someday, we'd like to hold here Education Human Values Training in Colombia. I assure you, all arrangements will be made by government. 5,000 teachers will be attending. Give us the date. Okay, sir. We'll settle. I'll keep in touch with you. So saying, I just return. That is the level of such seva. Understand that.
You can talk to anybody. It's all ready for verification. When I had been to Malaysia, and then Malaysia, believe me or not, Malaysia is a Muslim country. Right from the President, Prime Minister, External Affairs Minister, all Muslim rulers, members of the Cabinet, they all attend most necessarily such a service activity. That's what I'm saying. Prime Minister, President, they attend, they preside over our functions. There are Muslims. That's really thrilling. And the Minister for External Affairs, he attends morning session and wants me to see him in his office. And I went there for some press conference, cabinet meeting, some interview, whatever has happened, to whatever you brought me. I'm just a speck, Not even equal to the dust of your holy feet, Swami. You brought me this state. What is all this? Is it all true? Is it Maya? Or is it true? That's what I was feeling. It's a thrilling things happen in life when we are in association, Swami. I've been to Colombo, Sri Lanka. And Sri Lankan Prime Minister invites us for dinner, attended by cabinet ministers, Chief Justice, everybody. And then at the end he says, Anil Kumar, shall we have photo now? And who cares for my photo? Who? We thought, Baba, even if I give my photo freely, he will throw it on my face. Because he saw me there, photo got value. That's what happened in Sri Lanka. Here, one fantastic. In Indonesia, once again, the Muslim country. There what happens? In that Indonesia, the Seva Dal, you can talk to those people. Mr. Dinesh is the national chairman of such an organization in Indonesia, headquarters. A cup. The Seva Dal built 108 water tanks in Indonesia, supplying drinking water. On their own, They took me to some place, Borobudur, Yogyakarta, where medical camps are held. 5,000 people, 5,000. Patients are examined. Let us not think that I know Baba physically. Let me not think that Baba is only this much. No. Baba is cosmic. Baba is global. Vishwasarupa. Universal. Global. Don't make him an individual. Please understand. If you make him an individual, you are lost. You are not experienced his divinity. He is global. That's what I experience over there. Again in Latin America, Peru, the capital Lima. I was there. I attended the sadhana camp. Two girls, maybe around 25 or 30, they brought big bhajan book. Bhajan spoke. And they said, Uncle, whatever song you like, let us know who will sing. Can you say that? 1,000 songs are there. Now they say, come on, tell us whatever song you want, we'll sing. I felt very much ashamed of myself.
I don't think that I can sing so many songs. Even two songs I sing, they are translated by my friends, not by the general public. Here are the girls who said, ready to sing. And then in Peru, there is one interesting one of the seven wonders of the world, Machu Picchu or something they said. Machu Picchu. Then uncle, you should go tomorrow. Okay. See what Swami did. I could not get up from bed. Complete. Body stiff. Joints stiff. I could not get up. But yet I want to see Machu Picchu. What to do? I could not go. I could not walk up to the dining table. I could not go to the restroom. I was helped by two people. Somehow, I allowed myself to squeeze into the car to the airport. Suddenly, the wife of the president, who herself is Mahila coordinator in Lima, Peru, she comes straight to me. If you are to be my father, I will not allow you to go today. I will not allow you to go today. Let us go back. Your body is not cooperating. You have climbed so many steps, you cannot do it. Let's go. Who will tell you to a guest to continue to stay at your residence? We are interested to know when he would go. He has not even stepped into the house. When are you going to return? I got a return reservation made. These are the days today. They said, you are my father. I would allow you to go. Well, I stayed with them. And what news I get? It seems there in Machu Picchu, heavy rains it seems. Nobody could go. Therefore, Swami made me rest here. That is Bhagavan Sisa Seva. That is Bhagavan Sisa Seva. Outwardly, it may seem that my program is cancelled. I could not visit one of the seven wonders of the world. More than all seven wonders of the world, this eighth wonder, he made me take rest at home. He didn't allow me to go. That is what Bhagavan sees and said, Baba. I do not know what happened, what is happening. You cannot estimate, you cannot imagine either. I've been to West Indies, Trinidad, Tobago. I visited Guyana, Curacao, Barbados. I visited all those countries. For information, I tell you, in Trinidad, the government decided to implement in toto Sri Sathya Sai education in human values. At Curacao, the Deputy Prime Minister attended the meeting. When I was telling this, what is happening in Trinidad? She immediately came to the dais and said, why do you speak of Trinidad? Curacao will make it beginning from tomorrow morning. You know, I assure you as the minister, such a side moment is a whirlwind. It's a whirlwind. It is spiritual tsunami. You cannot stop it. You cannot stop it. The caravan moves majestically. We should know that. And he is with you always. He is with you always. It is rather surprising if I share with you a personal instance. Thailand, Bangkok, I was to visit. I went to the airport. It's my bad luck. Visa is not stamped. So they asked Mr. Anil Kumar, you can go back. We parcel you by the next flight. Oh ho, I have not come for this purpose. to return. Swami, aha, Desai Shankara, Natana Nageshwara. The meaning you will know then, not while singing. Swami, anything you do. I was just standing there. I couldn't understand Thai language. They say, Kafun Kap, Savari Kap. Welcome, goodbye. Those two words I know. That's those two words I know. So I was standing there. There comes a man with in a blue suit, a blue tie, with fine white stars on the tie. Well, well, nicely dressed. He walked to me. Are you Anil Kumar? I'm sure, sir, I am. What is the problem? Visa is not stamped. What am I to do? Please come with me, he said. I followed him. He took me to a room there where he immediately clicked the camera, prepared a passport size photo, stamped visa, you may go, they said. Then I came out. But ordinary I am. I was asking, how about my luggage? Visa is okay, I would have. And when you could come, do you think that your luggage will be taken? By the time we go, luggage will be there. By the time we went there, luggage straight to his car. Who is that gentleman? Sir, how is it that you are here? I came here to receive an international dignitary. I do not know that you are arriving today. I am Jun Sai of Thailand. You see, sir, Jun Sai name is very well known in Sai circles. An authority on education, human values. Wrote so many books, is an encyclopedia so far as educating human values is concerned. He got his PhD from Harvard. DSc from Oxford. Is related to the royal family of Thailand. Why should I give his biodata? There's a reason behind it. Sir, why do you want to stay here? You know, simply in the United States, drawing fat salary. You'd have gone to UK, then you'd be okay. How is that you wanted to be here? He said, I have learned from Swami to serve my own country, not to go elsewhere. You see the spirit of Sai. At one time Swami said, to be a beggar here is better than being a rich man elsewhere. Learn to serve your own country, he said repeatedly, time and again. That's what Jun Sai said. He is also a scientist, associate Viking, the space travel. And he settled there at his own place, running Sai School, Bangkok. Wonderful to see that. When you see that Bangkok Sai School, you will think of Sri Sathya Sai Primary School in Prashanthi Nilayam. Same replica. You will see the dusty road. You will also see something like Chitravati. You will see some master building. Same thing. Where is Baba now? Where is Baba? To think that he is in Prashanthi Nilayam, we can conclude that we are just at the lunatic asylum. Baba is everywhere. Baba is everywhere. How can I see him? Wherever his work is done, he manifests himself. Wherever his mission is taken up sincerely, he manifests so that you can see him. That's what Jun Sai said. I have seen his school. He has published about 15 books. most widely traveled man.
So humble, he plays harmonium, sings Baba bhajans excellently.
Why should I say this?
For the simple reason, my friends, all devotees, members of the organization, the prospective leaders, everyone should be an institution for himself. You should be able to sing. You should be able to serve as a Balankar's guru. You should be in position to serve in the capacity of a Seva other member. All in one is a sign, you would understand. So, I cannot say there are no singers today, so no bhajans. I see. Please start tonight. Do you do that? Yes, I can sing. Why not? And no Balankar's here. What are you doing? You can start. No service I do here. What service you are doing? So let every one of us take this role of a missionary, championship, to Sai Center, to start a Sai Center, and see that it grows on and on. Same in Thailand, my second experience, most unfortunately, I should think for second time if I am to be invited to Thailand once again. The second experience was equally bitter. Went to Bangalore airport. The luggage is already sent. Gone. There at the gate, the security officer checks my passport. Last page, there will be a number on the top. And the top will be at the bottom also, in the perforated portion. Same number. But when that man opened that, one number on the top side, different number. He said, this passport belongs to Ibrahim. I am not Ibrahim, nor Abraham. I am just Anil Kumar. Numbers don't tally. Please come and say. Sir, luggage has gone already. I see it will be back to you. Sir, supposing you allow me to go, what will happen? Will I be put in prison? Will I be jailed? No. But you have to catch the immediate next flight and go. That's all. Even if I leave you, there at the airport will catch you. Please go and go. Sir, tomorrow there is a very big meeting. I am suffering. Meeting takes place, if at all you have go there. You are not going. Then I requested him, sir, would you allow me to make a phone call to one gentleman? Singh, the president of Bangkok Sai Center, Manoj Kumar Singh. Why should I care to mention these names? Because of doubting thoughts. Because people may think that I generate miracles or create. Let not people doubt them in the wildest of the dreams. They are subject to verification. Any time, I am ready with their door numbers also. He said, you can't go. Sir, shall I make a phone call to Manoj Kumar Singh? Sorry, this government telephone, you cannot make use of it. I'll pay for it. It's not a public vote. Somehow he took pity upon me. This fellow is hanging around. Maybe Baba might have entered into his heart. Okay, sir, you make a phone call. There from Bangkok, Manoj Kumar picks up the receiver and says, sir, please talk to me. Security officer, there's no point in talking to me. Because he has to permit me. Please give it to him. He told him, let him come here. Rest Baba will take care of him. You allow him, that's all. Rest of things Swami will take care. All right, sir, go, he said. I said, but you are in the flight.
As it is advancing, heartbeat doubled and tripled. That I may be caught by the police there. That I may be asked to return. What is to happen? Then my namasmarana intensified. Japa magnified. Concentration totally focused. But there is no other way. Nobody can come to your rescue. I reach back. Swami save me. Two numbers are different. I am not Ibrahim, I am not Abraham. You are the only one who can save me, Swami. Yes, six. Six visitors to Thailand are ahead of me. And seventh one, there comes a man with a curly hair, quite handsome man, very well dressed, a blue colored suit, with an emblem here, United Nations Organization, UNO. He just came out and said, "Are you Anil Kumar?" "Yes, sir." "What's the problem?" "This is the problem. Insoluble problem." He said, "His name is Mr. Money. Money. Bangkok, Thailand. He hails from Australia and he settled there in Thailand. I am Money. I belong to UNO. No problem. You follow me." You follow me. I just went along with you. That lady, she didn't look at me. She looked at him. Okay. Is it possible? Is it possible any time to anybody? What is impossible for us is 100% possible to Bhagavan Sri Sathya Baba. Because again, I've been to Nagpur. I could not catch the Dakshin Express. I was very much delayed. I came to the college. What happened? And what happened? When I came to the college, doors are open, but nobody in the campus. I went and said, "What happened?" I asked lunch, "Sir, one lecturer is getting married today. So classes are suspended. College is here. Classes are suspended. Swami, let all these fellows get married so that I can serve you. So that my service will continue. Such that I would never lose my job." That's life is really exciting. Journey with Swami is full of excitement and thrill. Like that. Many, many, many things had happened in life. I tell you, my friends, water exists even without fish. Fish cannot exist without water. We cannot exist without Swami. And Swami is with me. Swami is an existential reality. Sat-chit. Ananda. Sat is existence. Chit is awareness. Ananda is bliss. Sat Chit Ananda is eternal witness. He continues to exist. But we need him. We want him. Let us understand that. Not that he wants. How can I say that? That people come and go. After all, what does he care? When he closes relation to his physical body, his second brother-in-law, to his physical body, died. Kasturi came close to Swami and said, "Swami, that man died." Swami was leaning on the pillar. Good. The people that is good. "Swami, that man is a friend of everybody. He talks to everyone. All are feeling very unhappy. He is no more." "You know what?" Swami said. "Kasturi, yen yatla bada padtao, yen anje papa. Chala tappu bangaru. Railway station master untaru.
స్టేషన్కి రైళ్ళు వస్తూ ఉంటాయి పోతూ ఉంటాయి. స్టేషన్ మాస్టర్ ఏడుస్తాడా, రైలు పోతే ఏడుస్తాడా, రైలు వచ్చినంత వేస్తాడా, జెండా ఊపటమే పని. రావడం పోవటం లేకపోతే అసలు స్టేషన్ మాస్టర్ ఉద్యోగమే లేదురా. వాట్ ఈస్ ఇట్ వాస్ యు హ్యావ్ రైల్వే స్టేషన్ మాస్టర్ అన్న రైల్వే స్టేషన్ మాస్టర్ ట్రైన్స్ అరైవ్ ట్రైన్స్ డిపార్ట్ I just think that's all very much. And if train arrives, I won't jump in joy. When train departs, I won't cry. So let people come, let them be gone, take off, landing. I'm just here to say hi, bye, bye. I am not affected. That is the spirit of the Lord. If any person saw me, my grandmother died. Chala santosham was there. How can there be santosham? స్వామి మై సన్ సక్సెస్ఫుల్లీ ఫెయిల్ ఇన్ దిస్ చాలా మంచి దేర్ నథింగ్ లైక్ చెడు నథింగ్ లైక్ బ్యాడ్ ఇన్ ద డిక్షనరీ ఆఫ్ స్వామి ఆల్ ఆర్ గుడ్ బర్త్ ఆర్ డెత్ సక్సెస్ ఆర్ ఫెయిల్యూర్ డిఫీట్ ఆర్ విక్టరీ ప్రాఫిట్ ఆర్ లాస్ బికాస్ భగవాన్ బాబా ఇస్ నాన్ డ్యూయల్ ఇస్ బియాండ్ is an eternal lesson. And I am not a person to simply give a talk and run away. I am not given to that. I am prepared to answer your questions. No reservations. Take it from me. Therefore, no fear. Let us discuss the members of the Sai family. Thank you for listening to me. Please have a good time.
Sir, my question is, for a small kid of maybe 5 years or 6 years of age, what is one thing which we should make him or her understand so that the kid can follow the path what Baba wants us to follow? One thing which we can make the kid understand.
Okay. Got newly married?
Yes.
How many children have you?
Pardon?
How many children have you?
How many children?
Only this guy. You have got such a problem with a small child. How about me with 4 children? Okay. Good sir. Thank you. Well, education starts at home. Mother is the first teacher. Father the next, and the teacher last. As per Bhagavan, 3 are important. Training of the mother, example of the father, and inspiration of the teacher, they are most important. Another time Baba said, if parents get up from bed, arguing with each other, as he looks above, children get up from bed fighting with each other. We start accusing each other when they get up fighting with each other. Therefore, education begins at home. We should be ideals so that every child would think, I should be like my mother. I should be like father. I should get a good name for them. I should earn a good name for myself and the institution I belong to. And the teachers who train me. That is spirit that has to be built. Next. In colleges, blanks in life. They don't have any values at all. In order, my friends, there may be some of you of my age. Many of you must be younger. But I appeal to you. Is more important to train the child in the value system than getting admission into colleges or institutions where we have to pay very high salary, very high fees. They learn nothing there. But if the child is brought up in a value system, whatever the child learns, will remain forever. If you want your children to love you, if you want children to be respectful to you, if you want your children to be grateful to you, if you want your children to be worthy of this nation, send them to Sri Sathya Balavikas. You will see what excellent improvement it is. It is the solution that I can make. Thank you very much. Yes.
Caught between staying positive and staying normal. If I read a newspaper or watch TV, I feel very depressed. But I feel that if I don't do that, am I becoming an ostrich or living in an idealistic, you know, cocoon?
Well, we can read newspapers, we can listen to news, but we should not become nuisance. We should have that sense of discrimination as to what is to be ignored as what is to be accepted. The good news also that would draw our attention. But if we are drawn towards these things, nonsense, everything is a reflection of the inner being. There is nonsense here, therefore that attracts me. Therefore, the sadhana is, a perfect practice is, not to be influenced by the negative forces, but to be encouraged by positive elements. Thank you.
I have seen number of families and households in Delhi and other places where Swami is bestowing his immense grace on them. They have vibhuti, they have amrit, and loads of things coming from the picture of Swami. But I feel happy in my satsang and in my seva. I don't feel the need to go there. Is that correct or wrong?
If you don't go there on grounds of jealousy, on grounds of envy, for reasons of prejudice, you are wrong. You feel it's not necessary. I feel encouraged from within. Divinity within, I feel like good. So going there or not is not the problem. The problem is, as I'm aware of the inner divinity, that is the problem. That is the question.
Absolutely.
Baba spoke about a golden age, is what we hear.
Ah.
Are we?
I never thought that Gurgaon is the center of intellectuals. Good. I've been here for the last 5 days. This is the platform where I am getting a volley of questions from you. Hats off, Zindabad. Gurgaon. Very good. And I feel very happy. I want questions as a teacher. I don't want to run away after giving a talk. Any fool can do it. I'm not here. I'm here to come closer to you, talk to you, and share my experiences. Yes. What she said is, world is in chaos, number one. What next?
Natural disasters.
Natural disasters, two.
National disasters.
National disaster, yes. What shall we do? First, let me question myself. How about my life? It is disastrous. Not national disaster. Not city is in disaster. My life is in disaster. What do you mean by disaster? Disaster is not to be calculated in terms of loss of private property or loss of lives. What is disaster? If I am restless, it is disaster. If I am peaceless, it is disaster. If there is no harmony, if there is no coordination, if there is no integration of the thought, word and deed, it is a disaster indeed. So if I avoid myself from personal, individual disaster, I'll be contributing something to the society rather looking at the society. Look to yourself. Let me look to myself. We are in disaster, we don't realize it. We see the disaster outside. I don't see the disaster within me. So it was pointing out the mole in the eye of others. Let me see the beam in my eyes. As Jesus Christ said, we are close to Christmas. Those quotations are ringing in my ears because of my Christian background. So let me just examine myself. Everything is set right.
Golden eggs.
Ah! And what are you, engineer? Software? But you seem to be hardware. Okay. What about the golden age?
See, one of Baba's miracles is we put the oil.
Please wait. There's a question from the floor. What is the golden age? Because it's a very interesting question. What is the golden age? When it is going to come? Few points for your thought and to ponder over and reflect. An age where all religions meet at one place in perfect harmony, unity, understanding, stressing upon the values and the practice of religion. Not merely the banner, it is the manner that is important. All religions joining together, hand in hand, what we call unity of faiths. That is happening today. If this is not golden age, what else can be golden age? What else? Two, we are living at a time when everything goes by sums of coin. Money. We earn money only to pay our medical bills. Not that, I don't say that you should not earn, you can earn. It's only means an end, but not an end by itself. At this stage, there are people who work selflessly, bearing their own travel expenses, buying their own money, sleeping in verandas, under the tree, doing selfless surveys throughout the year. If that is not golden age, what else could be? That's happening in Prashantalayam. All people in Prashantalayam, Sevadal, are volunteers. They don't receive any money. You go to the hospital, perfectly clean. You don't find any smell of glycerin or iodine or cotton pieces there. Because the very sight of hospital is to take away the life today. But it's not like that. Swami Hospital is a Kalyanamunta. It's very difficult to distinguish whether the patient is to be operated upon tomorrow or the patient is operated today or about to be discharged. All the three are fine. Why? The Sevadal working incessantly. The Sevadal services, as you walk, they immediately clean. If that is not the golden age, what else can be golden age? A village boy, or a boy from a village, hardly with 100 population, with no roads, with no power supply, with no medical facility, with no educational institution, could raise that village, a God-forsaken place at one time. Today, it is the Vatican of Hindu society. Prashantalayam, if that is not the golden age, what is it? So golden age does not mean metal gold.
See, there are so many times when there is Vibhuti or Amrit appearing on Baba's photographs.
Yes.
So what does it signify? Is it his blessings or just his visiting card, as he says?
I tell you, Vibhuti or Amrit or Kumkum or turmeric powder appearing on the pictures of Baba, they are not strange. They have been happening all these years. There are signs of His grace. There are signs of His benediction. There are signs of blessing. But they are not objects for publicity. They are not for propaganda. It is for your own glorification, for your own personal sadhana. And others should never envy about it. Others should never feel jealous of it. Others should never doubt it. You're lucky enough, you got it. So what? I congratulate you. A person known to me is specially blessed. I am blessed that way. That should be our thing.
A lot of people who are close to us, but their value systems are very different from what Baba teaches us. And people are very manipulative these days. And Baba says, love all for all. So how can you love people who are so different from us in value systems and they're so manipulative? I just want to know that.
Love all does not mean that you allow yourself to be cheated. Love all does not mean that you allow yourself to be exploited. Love is not foolishness. Love is not foolishness. Love is not ignorance. Love is not innocence. Love is sublime. Love is a greater power. So you can love, but don't hate. We can love, but we don't hate. By keeping everybody at a distance, I still love, so that I'll not be infected or contaminated by those bad qualities.
We always sing about Swami being very compassionate, Daya Maya, Karuna Maya and all. But there must have been instances when Swami would not, have been Karuna Maya in a different way by putting showing the person what his truth. This thing is. Can you tell us anything about it?
Like, you have not come out openly, you are hiding some facts.
No, I'm not hiding. I want to know, has Swami expressed his anger or this approval of any action to somebody openly?
Those who are specially close to him, close in the sense, official duties, they'll get heavily from him, mouthful. We think they are very fortunate angels, Swami talks to them every day. You step into their shoe, you understand. You will never allow you to be that close. You are useless, so you are smiling, ashram, you are not doing duty, I kick you. You want to be spoken to like that? No. So he corrects those for administrative purpose. But good and bad are the results of our own actions. మంచి చేసి చెడ్డను గాంచలేరు, చెడ్డను చేసి మంచిని చెందబోరు. నిమ్మంబు నాడ చూత ఫలంబులెట్లవును, సత్యమైన మాట ఈ సాయి మాట. వాట్ ఇవి వాట్ స్వామి, ఐ వాంట్ కోట్ ఒరిజినల్ టెక్స్ట్. When we quote Bhagavad Gita, we quote in Sanskrit. Why not? Baba said it, why not? That's my conviction. So, I'm quoting the original text that Baba said. Having done good, you never face bad results. Having done something bad, you can escape from bad results. As you sow, you reap. As is the action, so is the reaction. As is the floor, so is the pond. As is the cloud, so is the rain. As is the flame, so is the fire. As is the food, so you perish. So life is like that. Good and bad are the consequences of our own actions. That's all. Thank you.